within 24 hours, we have our 3D printed part ready to give to the surgeon to ensure a proper care and to ensure a good evaluation for the surgery. I'm Lars Brouwers. I'm a surgical resident in training, and furthermore, I'm a medical researcher in which I investigate the added value of 3D printing in complex fractures, and especially acetabular fractures. The Elizabeth II Stede Hospital is a major level 1 trauma center in the southern part of the Netherlands, and we take care of almost all the heavily injured patients, and they arrive on a daily basis by helicopter or by ambulance. We know it's very hard to understand the fracture patterns of complex fractures by using only 2D CT or X-ray. We started to print with the Ultimaker. Our goal was to investigate if 3D printing can be of added value in classifying acetabular fractures. Because of the classification, some people will take other steps or other types of surgery. So it works like this. The patient arrives in our hospital by helicopter or by ambulance. Once we've investigated the patient, we will make a CT scan and an X-ray of the injured part of the patient. And once the CT is ready, we've got our DICOM files. Within 5 or 10 minutes, our DICOM files are ready to convert into an STL file and finally into a 3D printed file. So within half an hour after arriving the patient in the hospital, our Ultimaker is up and running, and within 24 hours the print is ready to give to the surgeon or give to the resident to ensure a good evaluation for the surgery. We need to explain the operation to the patient, and using X-ray and 2D CT, it can be very hard for the patient to understand what is going to happen in his or her body. And with help of a 3D printed model, we think that our explanation can be more clear, can be better, and a patient has got a better understanding of what we are doing and what he or she has to do after the operation. The most important conclusions of our research is that 3D printing is of added value. We measured the classification in terms of intra-observer agreements. We call it kappa. And a kappa of 0 means that there's no agreement over the classification, and a kappa of 1 means there's a total agreement between the observers. And we noticed that when using X-ray and 2D CT, the most experienced surgeons and the students only reached a kappa of 0.2. But when they used 3D printed models, they reached a kappa of almost 0.7, which internationally can be seen as a good inter-observer agreement between the observers. That's really showing us that 3D printing can be of added value, for example, especially for the younger generation. By doing a lot of research, we hope that we can prove that 3D printing can be of added value in patient satisfaction, in surgical satisfaction, in reduction of operation time, and in the health-related quality of life for the patient, because that's the most important thing.